It's a perfect morning on Potholes Reservoir in eastern Washington. We're with guide Shelby Ross and Bobby Loomis of Max Lure, along with Ray Thurford and Todd Storm.
We're headed out of Mardon Resort here on Potholes Reservoir. We're going to get some walleye today. We've got a nice breeze. Should be a beautiful day. We're going to start on a weed line that's produced a bunch of our fish the last 2 days and a bunch of our fish the last couple years. We'll start there, see if they're still there. We had a big breeze last night. We had 25 plus mile an hour wind, so we'll see if they moved around on us or if they're still right where they were when we left them yesterday, and we'll go get them. So the walleye are post-spawn. It's late June. They're just basically eating everything they can catch. There's tons of bait fish. The newly spawned walleye, perch, largemouth, smallmouth, all the little bait fish that are yay big are in these weed patches for cover, and the walleye are right behind them, eating them out of house and home. So we're fishing a slow death rig with the night crawler that's spinning, it's rotating. Every time you go to go down, you wanna make sure you have that spin. If you don't have that spin, we need to adjust your bait, and you wanna make sure that leader is not wrapped around the weight so that swivel can spin freely, otherwise it starts twisting up your leader. And then with your thumb, just enough line to hit the bottom. It's 9 foot deep. You just want to just barely tick along the bottom. When the fish hits, you got to force yourself not to do the normal human nature thing of just yarding on it. You got to let them eat it long enough to get to that hook. When they load the rod tip, when your weight feels twice as heavy, nice smooth forward pull and reel.
On any of my trolling applications, I always run a smile blade up on top of my swivels. Basically, what you're doing is just adding a little more added attraction. Now, like what Shelby's got going on today, everything's a little bit on the minimal side. So it might be a little bit too much. We'll find out. But I'm going to start out with one of our setups with the same slow death rig. Thread it the same way, but with a few beads and a smile blade. It emulates one of the different forage bases in the system here. You've got everything from crawdads to small bait fish, mud minnows, sculpin, you name it, they got them in here. So you try to mimic those colors or what that forage base is that the fish are looking for.
Hey Bobby, these beads UV?
Yeah.
Because we've got the Angler West tool here. It's got a UV light. Right.
Nice.
In front of it. So you can just hit these, look at that.
Oh yeah.
Hit those up.
Absolutely. Yeah, I got a glow bead on top of everything. Yeah. Almost all of our products are walleye products. I like putting a glow bead up on top, underneath the smile blade, because it gives it that strobe light almost effect.
Just a little extra, right?
A little extra, absolutely. Yeah, use everything to your benefit.
Yeah. That's cool. Neat lake. Glad to be somewhere different doing different things. It's a really neat lake. I like it. I like the way they're working. They got a big horseshoe weed edge here, and he's just working right along the edge of them. Yeah, it looks like it should be fun.
I don't know what we got going on here.
Stick?
It's a big fish.
Is it a fish?
Yeah.
Big fish.
That's a throwback fish.
It's a 22, 23 inch start.
Nice fish. Yeah, it is.
Fat, healthy. We're going to let this guy go. These fish this size are our breeding females that help the population continue. What color?
Gold.
Gold. This guy back in the water here.
When fishing Potholes, stay at the family-friendly Mardon Resort with plenty of options for large groups and families. Go to mardonresort.com for information. Welcome back to Potholes Reservoir. I'm Justin Wolf. Potholes is known for its great walleye fishing, and today we started off with a big, beautiful female that fell for a gold smile blade, which may be the answer today.
Well, the gold smile blade, like I said, you're emulating some type of forage base in here, which is most likely a mud minnow type pattern or something that these fish are feeding on.
Or a walleye. And,
what's that?
Or a walleye.
Or yeah, you're small walleye. I mean, you've got a number of different things to look in that realm.
This is just a bare slow death, and the last couple days it has really been producing without any color in front of it, and looks like Bob is on a mission to show me that gold is the color of the day. And oftentimes you just, you start with what was working the day before and slowly change your pattern to whatever they want that day. And they, I'm 0 for 3. He just got bit off with this one, but the only fish in the boat is on that gold smile blade. So one fish doesn't mean a pattern, but you get three of them and all of a sudden we're changing some gear.
Everybody wants one?
Yeah.
Man, how close can you get there?
He's on you now?
Yeah, there we go, got him.
We got him. Second bait's a charm, huh?
Yeah, exactly.
Nice fish.
Nice one.
Number two on the goal.
There's a fish taco.
Or a few.
Nice 19 inch fat walleye.
Yeah, that's three on the gold. We might have a pattern going. Maybe.
Dinner size fish.
Yep.
Foot of boat.
Yeah.
Here, get the net. Here. I got it. Chunky. Nice fish.
Oh, I got that.
Looks like I got the big one again, Todd. Yeah, right on.
You've been on there for a little bit.
That's the thing about these, you'll sit there and you'll look like what he had. That fish is sitting there pecking on it, and you think that fish is just following and pecking on it. Hell, they probably had it in his mouth, And they swim right with it. They'll just stay with it. No tension, no nothing. But just you can feel them chewing on the whole thing.
All right, I'm going to demonstrate how to fillet a walleye here. It's a nice 19-inch fish. Fish this big, there's plenty enough meat in the cheek to make it worthwhile to get it out. So we'll do it first. That's my favorite part right there, is the cheek meat. Right behind the fins. Down the backbone. So we've got the fillet off here now. We're gonna rinse. Get some slime off, it's easier to grip. And this is the tail end. Put your thumb right in the center. And just pull both halves. Peels out across like that. That side's clean, ready for the bag. This side's got this strip, this darker meat and these little pin bones. You pinch that strip, peels right out of there like a zipper. And remember, it's a one-way zipper. You have to pull from the tail end. It will not pull from the other end. It'll just come apart in pieces, so. And it's nothing but pure white meat.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.